Let's wait. There are only 7 students so far.
Hello,
only 12 students. So how many assignments I have given? 4 assignments, right? Hello? Hello, can you hear me? Hello, Rudika.
Yes, sir.
How many assignments I have given? Can you please tell me names of the assignments? First is prism to prism. Second, Yes. Cylinder and phone. Then third is what is the third? And what is the fourth? You remember or you have forgotten?
So second is cone and cylinder, and the fourth one was auxiliary views of the cylinder.
Yeah, so that's the end of the assignments on the intersections. So now you will have assignments on modeling. Let us see. Now there are some issues with the laptops. Students, they don't have laptops. Let us see now what the management is going to take the decision. So now there won't be any assignments. I mean, there will be assignment, but that will be on the modeling, and that will be on the software called as UniGraphics, not on the AutoCAD. UniGraphics, NX5 or NX11. What? Let us see. How does our CAD/CAM lab starts? The deadline is 10th of August. That is for the submission of the last assignment. Of course, these marks will be counted in your term work, which is 50 marks there. So these marks will be converted into 10 marks. All these, the four assignments there, that will be mapped to the 10 marks, and remaining 40 marks will be based on the solid modeling. So in case there we have to do some five assemblies, in case suppose because of the shortage of time, suppose if we are unable to complete, then this intersection will be given, will be mapped to 20 marks, and then modeling that assembly dismantling will be for 30 marks. So like that it will be. But definitely the weightage will not be more than 20 for this intersection, and then that's the maximum, and 30 marks for the 3D modeling, that is assembly, and you have to do detailing also. So five assemblies we have to do. Let us see how does this, you know, pandemic, and how do we come out, and when do we come to the college? Let's wait. Otherwise we look for some other alternatives. Okay, now I'll start because already some 16 students they have joined. So there are two more theory topics left. That is, one is machine elements, and another is limits, fits, and tolerances. So that will cover up in today's lecture and then next Thursday lecture. There is no assignment on today's lecture as well as on next Thursday lecture. It's totally a theoretical lecture, but it is important. From the understanding, it is very, very important, this limit speed tolerances as well as machine elements. It's very important. I'm not presenting window now, I'm presenting the entire screen. We'll try to cover up this module 1, then quarter joint, quarter joint, and quarter joint assembly. This is what is your module 1 is. This part we have completed, this solid geometry. We have completed intersection of surfaces and interpenetration of solids, prism or cylinder with prism. So we have done prism to prism, cylinder or cone. So we have done cylinder to cylinder. Then we have done cylinder to cone. Both the solids in simple position only, then primary auxiliary views and auxiliary projections of the simple machine parts. So that also we have done one exercise. So that last date is 10th of August. And for the earlier three assignments, the last date was 3rd of August. So now let us cover up this machine elements in preparation of 2D drawings of standard machine elements, that is what is nut, what is bolt, what is key, what is cotter, what is screws and spring. Out of this, cotter is a bit difficult, so I have a video for that also. And then conventional representation of assembly of threaded parts in external and sectional views. Then what are the type of the threads and how do you designate the threads. Then conventional representation of machine components and materials and designation of standard components. So this is what we are going to see today. This I already uploaded. Just for the reference only, this is. No questions will be asked as of on the in the examination theory as well as practicals. Practical exam is fully on modeling. Now, how to represent, that is conventional representation. So you have, you know, metals. Metals means you have mild steel, you have stainless steel, you have chromium steel, you have brass, you have bronze, you know, so many ceramics, etc. So it is ferrous as well as non-ferrous. So in the drawing, so far just you are just making some sketches, you know, just drawing some lines. Now it will have actual use, isn't it, in the society or engineering applications. Like suppose if you want to make a bridge, or if you want to make a machine, or lathe machine, making of lathe machine, like manufacturing of milling machines, so, or manufacturing of subcomponents, like say engine or say cylinder. So every product has, you know, certain material depending upon the use. Like suppose if the ductility, or if the product is to be rolled, you know, if you want like sheets, then the product has to be malleable. If you want wires, then the product has to be ductile. So you have to go for copper or you have to go for aluminium. So in the drawing, so far you are just familiar with the lines and some kind of visualization. But when you actually industry ready drawings, when you draw industry ready, that is use which is to be used by the industry, then you need to use some symbols so that the reader or the customer, he understands. So now see, these are the lines. Usually this angle is taken as 30 degree. So if the material is of steel or of cast iron or copper, copper and its alloys. Copper and its alloys means like Mohn's metal. Different copper alloys. Then bronze, then brass. These are all copper alloys. That is copper plus zinc, copper plus tin. Then aluminium and its alloys. Aluminium and its alloys means aluminium 3018, aluminium 2018, and duralumin. So all those are represented by these lines, which are inclined on the right hand side. You cannot draw ulta. It has to be drawn on the right hand side and at an angle of 30 degrees. Right? Then if it is a soft metal, like say lead, soft metal, compared to softer, like your pencils, leads, no? Pencils. Pencils are your right eye, that is made up of lead. So you can crush by hand. Zinc, tin, white metal, they are all soft metal. So that is to be represented in the drawing. Like suppose in an assembly, suppose if you have an assembly of say plumber block or say screw jack, or say tool post, you are making the assembly, and in that assembly suppose the component is made out of say lead or of say zinc, then you have to represent it by two lines, right hand as well as left hand, inclined at both the, you know, that is plus 30 or minus 30. So this is how it will look like, the second figure. Then third, suppose you want to show the glass. This you may be familiar also. You might have seen some, you know, architectural drawing. It is a design drawing. So the grass is shown like this. You have one big line, and opposite you have two shorter lines. That is one big line, then shorter line, and still shorter line. That is for the glass. And this is used, this material is used in civil engineering. That is marble, and stoneware, and slate, porcelain. So that's, see, every line there is a difference. See, this is a continuous line, whereas this is your dotted line, a dotted line, broken lines. So that represents your civil engineering material, building materials. Building means any construction. Can be bridges, it can be roads. Then this is something like, you know, temperature resistance material, like you have asbestos and fiber and felt, synthetic resin products, rubber products, paper, cork, rubber, leather, wax, insulating and filling materials. So something which is related to the heat or temperatures. So you have one inclined line and another horizontal lines. Generally, this is also called the packing and insulating material. Liquids is the simplest. You are familiar how to show the liquid. Liquid can be your water, oil, petrol, except gas. So that's why I cannot, or we cannot call this as a fluid, because gas is a fluid, but so therefore we use the word liquid, like water, oil, petrol, kerosene, and we are not using the word fluid, because fluid means which flows, gas flows, so that's why gas comes under the category of fluid. This is used by the interior people, interior decorators, carpenters, that is wood and plywood. This, like if you cut a typical CTC or that is a teak wood or BTC, then at cross section if you see from the side, it will look like this. So that's why generally all the woods are represented by this symbol. Again, this is for the construction, that is cement, sand, gravel. So this represents your concrete. So this diagram, it was a representation of the different materials which is used in civil industry, mechanical industries, thermal industries. And obviously we are not making any electrical drawings, isn't it? So definitely we are not concerned about those symbols, electrical symbols, circuit symbols. We are not doing any piping drawing also, piping. So that also we are not concerned about. So basically we are concerned with mechanical, you know, symbols. So the scope is limited to mechanical and civil industries, not other industries. Like, so in other industries you will have symbols, you know, for relays, contactors, push buttons, electrical, electronics, diodes, triodes, you know, symbols. Then in piping also you will have symbols for taps, for walls, for the joints, for the elbow joints, for the T joints, but that is not under our scope. Right? Typical bolt will look like this, right? This is called the hexagonal bolt. Why it is called the hexagon? Because this the head. See, this portion is for the head, and this portion, the longer one, is called the stem. Because any of the, sometimes even the engineers which are graduating, you know, after doing 4 years of course, I'm sorry to say, but they are not able to identify, you know, physically, which one is nut, which one is bolt, which one is ball bearing, which one is, you know, thrust bearing, because of lack of, you know, practical experience. So, here, production engineering, our major focus is on, you know, practice. This is head and this is stem. Now, it is called the hexagonal because the head is hexagonal. Now, head can be square also. Head can be octagonal also. So, it depends. Like, suppose, it depends to how many degree you want to rotate. Like, suppose, If you want to rotate through 90 degree, that 90 degree rotation is sufficient. Then you can go for square head. See, there is a theory behind whether to go for square, whether to go for hexagon. Just not randomly we are taking hexagon. But in most of the cases, that is joints, hexagonal head finds sufficient, you know, application. So that's why normally most of the bolts or the nuts are hexagonal headed. So if I want to rotate to 60 degree, then I'll go for hexagonal and so on. These are generally forged. These manufacturing processes, forging. It's basically a cold forging process. In cold forging process, you get this blank without threads. There are no threads. You get this head and you get this blank. Then after that, you have to turn this. You have to turn the blank. That is, you have to turn the stems, and then you have to cut the threads. You have to cut the threads, these threads. So the threads are cut on the rolling machine. That is a machine that is called the thread rolling machine. Only the threads are cut. That is a faster process, generally used for mass producing the threads. Alright. Now again, there are various, and you know the application of nut and bolt. It is used for joining of two plates, any two components. Nut and bolts, isn't it? And the advantage is that the assembly can be dismantled at any time, isn't it? So it is not a destructive kind of assembly. Like suppose if you go for, say, riveting, I hope you understand this little bit. I know you are second year student, that too, third semester. But then you try to understand or Google it. Like suppose if you go for riveted joints, what you can see on the railway platforms, railway bridges, not platform, railway bridges, you will see the railway bridges for your plates and niche ka. The Juna station, the old stations, not the new stations, it is all concrete. But if you go, if you visit the older stations, there you will find, you know, all the bottom flooring is made up of plates, steel plates, and those are all rivets. Even the sides, you know, the bridge for the sides there, there are also MS plates are used and they're all riveted. The disadvantage of rivets is that if you want to suppose dismantle these two plates, then how to remove the rivets? Because that becomes a permanent joint. Then you have to drill it. You have to drill and remove the rivets, and then only you can dismantle. Then another joining process is welding. You can weld, but then welding again, suppose if you want to dismantle, then again you have to gouge it. Gouge means you have to cut that welding by, say, oxyacetylene torch, using oxyacetylene torch. And so this riveting and welding, brazing, soldering, those all becomes a destructive kind of thing. Whereas nut and bolts is what? It's not destructive. You can, whenever you want, you assemble, whenever you want, you dismantle. Only the problem is for the nut and bolt that you have to have a hole in the component. So that's an additional operation. So you need to drill a hole in the both the products so that your bolt can go, and then you can tighten the nut. There are again many types of threads. These are called as the threads. There are V threads, then there are V threads are metric threads, then there are British standard. BSW thread, British standard thread, Whitworth thread, then there are pipe threads, there are knuckle threads, there are Acme threads, so many, buttress thread, square thread, depending upon the application, that is where you are going to use the bolts or the nuts, and it has wide applications. You are using it in measuring instruments also, isn't it? So measuring instrument, the nuts are, the threads are very fine. Very fine thread, the V thread, very fine. What do I mean by fine? Fine means the pitch is very small. That is the meaning of fine. The pitch is nothing but the distance between two consecutive threads. That is called as the pitch, or it is technically it is defined as the distance through which the nut or the bolt moves axially in one rotation. That is what is called as the pitch. And every now you cannot show in the drawing the bolt like this, isn't it? So you have to represent it symbolically. Symbolically. This is hexagonal headed bolt, bolt nut. Again, you can have hexagonal headed, or you can have square, you can have round also. And the chambers are provided here. This just to, because normally we don't keep anything sharp, but sharp corners are dangerous because they fail very easily because of the stress concentration. Because I have been telling you, sharp corners, sharp area means area zero, stress is equal to load upon area. So when area is zero, the stress is infinite, maximum stress. And whenever any body or any member is subjected to maximum or high stress, then obviously that member is going to fail. So you have to give some generous chamfer. Of course, you have to also check the application of application. So that was your nut. So there are symbols to represent bolts and nuts, and there are some standard specification also by which you can order your bolt and nut. That is how to order the bolt and nut. Like suppose if I say M for mother, if I say M20 by 2, so M20 by 2, the meaning of M is metric, and 20 is nothing but the outside diameter of the bolt, and that 2 is nothing but the pitch, that is the distance between two consecutive threads. So this is how you have to order, and like that, every element, machine element is specified. This is your square headed bolt. Again, I am telling these are forged. Forged matlab garam karke dabana. Like in layman's language, we call it the lohar kaam. Lohar. Patti mein garam karke usko shape dene. It is not, nut and bolt manufacturing industry is not so crude. It's very much sophisticated. So there also you have, numerical control machines. And it's quite a sophisticated plant. Like you have, TVS fasteners, you have precision fasteners, Sundaram fasteners. There are many fasteners companies, TVS, Sundaram, precision in Bombay. Ani Bedapur Road, near to Airoli, you have this precision fasteners. Precision TVS and Sundaram, they are from the south. So you have square headed bolt and you have square headed nut also. The purpose of giving this is it can be held in a wrench, because if it is round, then you cannot hold it and rotate it. Hold it and rotate it. Now here we see a nut and bolt assembly. So this is a nut and this is a bolt. Alright. There are two nuts shown here, and the head is, it's kind of a concavity which is given here, or convexity. We call it the mushroom type heads. So it depends upon the application. So two nuts are used when you want to lock something, So two nuts. That time you use the two nuts, and they are in contact with each other. That is, this nut you have to take it ahead, or ye jo nut hai, that you have to take it below, and then you have to touch face to face. The purpose of lock nut is that it cannot get loosened during working. There is a tendency that if the nut is not tightened properly with proper torque or with proper leverage, then that may get loosened, and then some accidents may happen. And that's why you have to go for lock nut kind of thing. So these are your two nuts, mean lock nuts. You are locking them, so it's not possible to, loosen. It cannot be loosened very easily. Now, if you hold the nut, that is, you are holding the nut and you don't allow nut to move, and if you rotate the ball, this is what is very important. Then there will be two motions, that is ball is going to rotate as well as the ball is going to advance in and out. That is kind of a right hand, you know right hand screw rule. You learn this in physics, right hand screw rule. Or if there is no motion given to the bolt, that is, if you hold a bolt, that is, you are not allowing to rotate the bolt, or you are not allowing to move the bolt actually, then if you rotate the nut, then obviously your nut will advance. And this is what the principle of your machine tools is. Many of the students, they don't understand it. So principle of machine tools, how does the table move? How does the table move? This bolt is nothing but a screw, you know, lead screw, which is connected to the motor. Bolt is nothing but a screw, which is connected to the motor. And this nut is connected to the table. A table is resting on the nut. Of course, it will not be some small nut like this. It will be bigger and stronger, well-designed nut. So now what happens? As the motor rotates, screw rotates. But screw is not allowed to move axially. Screw is not allowed to move axially. So that means nut will move axially. Axially means along the axis of the bolt. And since the table is connected to the nut, definitely your table is going to move down. Alright? So that's a simple, you know, nut and bolt assembly which is used for movement of the table. You know, so I have been telling you, nut and bolt is used only for the assembling two components, but not really. All machine tools, tables, you know, they use this screw and the nut philosophy. So that was one machine element. Then you have next machine element, which is called as the key. की मतलब अपना वो अपना नॉर्मल अपना ताले का चाबी नहीं, हम लोग दरवाजे को लगाते हैं, नॉट दैट. आई डोंट नो वेदर यू आर फैमिलियर विद द एप्लीकेशन और विद द यूज ऑफ द की. आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ द की. हियर दिस रेक्टेंगुलर पीस, दिस called as the key. This form of key will be. This is called as the key. Right now you are in a position to understand what is shaft and what is bush. So this is what is your shaft and this is what is your a bush kind of thing is. So this is your shaft and this is your bush. I'm going slowly. Wood little up. In this sectional drawing, this is your shaft and this is bush. So bush means it's nothing but a piece having a hole inside. We can say this bush as a collar type bush. This we can say as a collar bush. Collar type of bush. Now imagine that there is no key. And you are mounting this bush directly on the shaft. Shaft is always for driving something, isn't it? So now suppose this shaft is connected to the motor. Motor rotates and this shaft rotates. So what will happen to the bush? Bush may rotate or bush may not rotate. Why? Because no matter, there will be some clearance between this shaft and the bush. There will be clearance between the shaft and this bush. Because of that clearance, this bush will slip. And then our purpose of rotating the bush will not be solved. And since it slips, it may rotate, it may not rotate, it may rotate jerky, thoda ghuma, band ho gaya, like that. But we don't work like that, isn't it? If this is rotating at 1000, bush pulses should rotate at 1000. Why this is happening? Because the bush is free to rotate. We call it as a free to rotate. Bush is rotating freely. How to overcome this problem? This bush है, इसका जो होल साइज है दैट आई विल मेक अंडर साइज लोअर देन द शाफ्ट साइज मीन्स सपोज इफ द शाफ्ट साइज गिविंग एन एग्जांपल द शाफ्ट साइज इज से 50 देन आई विल मेक दिस होल साइज इफ आई मेक दिस होल साइज एज 50.1 दैट इज बिगर देन दिस बुश विल गो लूज इफ आई मेक दिस बुश 49.9 then I have to hammer it and that is what is called as the interference fit. I have to hammer it. So that is what is called the interference fit. Now that means it is going very tight. In that case, sometimes even interference fits are obtained by hitting the component. Hitting the component means what we do? This is 49.9, it's not going, so we hit it. Not the entire component, we just flame hit the ID that is hole. So that it expands and it becomes bigger. Now, in the hot condition only, we assemble using some tongs, etc. And then when it pulls, it shrinks. Okay, and when it shrinks, it fits tightly. And now, suppose if this is rotating at 1000, so this will rotate at 1000. It may rotate, may not rotate, depending upon the load what it is carrying. You know, if the load is very heavy, then even that interference fit also will not be sufficient. It may slip. But assuming that load is not so heavy, in that case, it can rotate. But then what is the disadvantage of this interference fit? Tomorrow, suppose if I want to, you know, assemble another bush, then how do I remove? I have to do hammering. Isn't it? Gun se maarna padega. Or again, I have to hit it. And again, I have to hammer. So two things will happen. Lot of labor request, isn't it? This pieces, there are chances that it may get damaged. And most important is, it is time consuming. Okay. So in order to avoid this, we have to go for something which is very easy. We use a piece, that is this rectangular piece, which we call the key. And half of the key goes inside the shaft and half of the key goes inside the bush. It is also what is the collared bush or it is also what is the hub, HUB. And it will look like this. If you see here, front view and this is side view. So you have a collared bush in which you have cut a keyway, a slot kind of things, that is for the keyway. And that is kept on this shaft. And then you are inserting a key. Now because of this key, and it looks like this, the drawing will look like this, this is a key, this is a powder bush. Now, because of this key, when this shaft rotates, even if there is a clearance, that is, this is a 50 and this is 50.1, even if there is a clearance, because of this key, once this shaft rotates, the hub will also rotate, because there is a key inside this. So this becomes a one piece of only. Now it can move actually along the axis, it can move. But for that we can have blind key, or normally most of the times we put collar from both the sides, we put collar or we put spacers from both the sides, that is we put spacer over here and we put spacer here, collar kind of thing. So that we restrict the movement, axial movement, and the rotational movement or the rotational slip is avoided by the key. Alright. Then for the ease of assembly, we give a small amount of taper. So that the key can be inserted properly because of the draft. And usually the taper is 1:100. Means 1:100 means the size will increase by 1 mm over a length of 100 mm. Size will increase by 1 mm over a length of 100 mm. That is what the meaning. Like suppose if I have a 100 50 dia at one end and other end is say 150 dia. So whenever I say 1 in 100, that means it has to be 151, like that. 1 in 100 or 1 is 200 ka matlab hai, if here the size is say, if this width or if this thickness is say 20, then for a length of 100 mm, it will become 21 at the other end. So over a length of 50, it will become 50.5. In a length of 25, it will become 50.25, like that it is. And this is how it is represented, 1 in 100. So it is represented. Again, keys are standard. These sizes are fixed. Okay, like in bolt and nut, that is M12 or M20/2. So like that also, the keys are also standard keys. These are standard. There are different type of keys, again depending upon the use, out of which I am sure that one key you are familiar, that is Woodruff key. Since you have done, you know, practicals on death machine, you might have seen that Woodruff key on the tool post. Woodruff key allows you to adjust the height of the tool. I have also shown you Woodruff key. It's a kind of a semicircular key, so your tool height can be adjusted and your tool can be matched exactly with the center of the workpiece. So different keys, square keys, saddle keys, Woodruff keys. As I said, the slope is 1 inch 200. So this is the shaft, the round shaft. Yeah. Now, so it has an advantage now, isn't it? You can quickly do the assembly and dismantling. Only now, what is the disadvantage? Now, disadvantage is that you have to cut a slot in the shaft. So that's an additional operation, and that you will be doing by milling. You'll be doing on milling machine. Then you have to also do slot cutting on the bush. So that is your slotting operation, which is done on the reciprocating machine, which is called as the slotting machine. Two things. And third thing, that you have to have a key. You have to either order it or you can make on your own. So that's an additional manufacturing. Whereas suppose if you're using interference fit or a loose fit, interference fit may, you just make a shaft, you just make a bush having a hole. No need to cut a slot here, no need to cut a slot here, no need to have key, and then simply hammer it by heating it. But then, if you want to dismantle, then the probability of, you know, damaging the component is very high. So you have a hollow saddle key in the saddle. Saddle key, simple, normal, our rectangular key is called as the saddle key. Saddle. In the saddle key, you have hollow saddle key and flat saddle key. You have to just remember flat saddle key, because hollow saddle keys are not used. Woodruff key is used popularly. Woodruff key. It will look like this. Woodruff key. This is what the application is. Woodruff key. It's a semicircular. Now you have, now in your lathe machine, you have tool post. And in the tool post, the Woodruff key is kept below the tool. So the moment you move this key in this direction, that is, if you're pushing it, that is, you have to just tap a little bit, then what is going to happen? See, this distance is going to change from this point to this center line. It is going to change, isn't it? Suppose if this is 50 R, so when the key is exactly at the center, this distance will be 50. But if it moves now little out, then 55 will become 49 to 48, like that it is, isn't it? So this whatever tool which is resting is going to fall down little bit, isn't it, by 1 mm. So that is the purpose of Woodruff key. Woodruff key. Again, now here, since these are all standard elements, machine elements, the dimensions are also standard. Dimensions are also standard. And the reference is taken as the diameter of the shaft. So it is all based on the diameter of the shaft. Got it? Diameter of the shaft. So once you know the diameter of the shaft, then the rest of the dimensions you can find out. So let's say if the D is the diameter of the shaft, if it is 50 mm, then thickness of the key will be 1 by 4 of 50. 0.2 can be 1 by 4. So that will be 12.5. Then diameter of the key, small d, will be 3 times width. So once you have width, then you can get this. You can get, so everything is expressed in terms of d. You have to just understand only. You don't have to learn anything. You don't have to remember, because this will not be asked in the examination. You have to just remember, yes, if there is something Radicular's orders, P, the function of P, the different type of keys, there was something called the Woodruff key, yeah, which is used for making the adjustments for aligning. And there is something, there are some relations. There are some relations with the help of which, if you know the diameter, you can find out the dimensions of the pura, you can find out the details. You can make the detailed drawing of the key. This much you should make, isn't it? Then, if somebody wants to learn in detail, yes. Like suppose when you join a design industry, then if you remember this, then yes. Now, how to get the dimensions? Yes, there are design data books, isn't it? PhD design data, OM tools. So you can refer those. So absolutely, you don't have to learn. But you should know what is available where, and some basics you should. Suppose if you don't know at all what is key, then helpless, isn't it? Then definitely Samne wala bolega, sorry, we cannot take you. So the interviewer will not ask you, how do you find out the height, tell me the relation, but he will definitely ask you, what is the function of the key, why the key is used. It's a common question, people ask, interviewer asks. Because the students, they don't understand what do you mean by free movement of the bush, and what do you mean by fixed movement of the bush. Then knurling, and knurling, you know the purpose of knurling is to have a good grip. Like suppose if you are not using a spanner takes time, isn't it? Spanner uthao, usko lagao, barabar, then usko ghumao. Again, it's rotate for again, boom out. It takes time. So, imagine instead of spanner, suppose you are simply rotating by hand, isn't it? It's very quick. So, these are for the quick joints or quick assemblies. Right? So, straight knurling is represented by this straight horizontal lines. It can be also represented by cross lines, also. Basically, it shows the pattern, also. Pattern. Because knurling, as I explained while teaching this, there are patterns of the nulls. It gives some good look. Otherwise, functionally, straight null or diamond null is the same. But diamond nulls, it looks bit better than straight null. So, aesthetic point of view, people go for diamond null. So diamond nulling is shown like this. Diamond nulling is nothing but a cross type of nulling. Then, try to understand this drawing. Right. You want, I will enlarge it. I'll zoom kardau. Right. How to represent a square on the shaft? Now, shaft means usually it is round, isn't it? It's a circular. And how do you understand that it is circular or it is round? Because of this center line. And we write there that diameter 20. So that symbol is there. That dia symbol. Either you write DIA or you use that phi symbol, isn't it? Greek alphabet. With that, you understand that this is round, isn't it? But now, if I want to, clamp this shaft, assemble this shaft, so Obviously, I need to use a spanner on the shaft, and since it is round, the round will have only a point contact, isn't it? And what we want a surface contact, isn't it? So here, with the help of a spanner on a round portion, we only get a point contact and line contact across the width of the spanner. We get a line contact, but we want surface contact. So in order to get that, what we do, somewhere we mill flat or a square. यहाँ पे हम लोग फ्लैट मारते हैं और चार स्क्वायर बनाते हैं. इधर एक फ्लैट लाइक दिस, एक फ्लैट, एक फ्लैट, एक फ्लैट. दिस इज अ मिलिंग ऑपरेशन. वी डू फ्लैट मिलिंग एज पर द साइज ऑफ द स्पैन. राइट, एंड हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट दैट, हाउ द पीपल विल अंडरस्टैंड. यस, यू हैव अनदर व्यू, दैट इज साइड व्यू. बट सपोज इफ यू डोंट वांट टू ड्रॉ द साइड व्यू, सपोज इफ आई एम लेजी और इफ देयर इज नो स्पेस. Most important, if there is no space to draw the side view, then it can be simply represented like this. So it's a line mark. That's all. The meaning of this is no more round, but it is square. This is no more. This particular, only this much. Rest is round. Only this portion is not round, it's square. So this is how you represent a square on the shaft. Holes. And of course, you have to write here, square 20. For the size, you have to show, no? So just draw arrow and say 20 mm square or 25 mm square. Now, holes. See, there are now here, how many holes are here? There are 12 holes. If we space at 30 degree. So there is no need to show, you know, अच्छा लगता है, अच्छा दिखता है, बिकॉज़ अननेसेसरी इट बिकम्स, ड्राइंग बिकम्स कंजेस्टेड. सो दैट टाइम व्हाट यू डू, यू जस्ट ड्रॉ ओनली वन होल, ओके, एंड यू ड्रॉ एन एरो एंड से डायमीटर 6, डायमीटर 6 होल इक्वी स्पेस्ड एट 30 डिग्री. दिस इज वन. और यू कैन सिंपली से डायमीटर 6 कॉमा 12 नंबर्स, दैट्स ऑल. I mean 6, 12 number. It means there are 12 holes. And show the center line. Even if you don't show the center line, that's also fine. Then we show only, there are two ways. Draw this one hole and draw the center lines, 12 center lines, or draw the one hole and simply write 6, 12 numbers. That's all. This is what the most important is, and many of the students, they don't know this bearing. Next year you will learn theory of machines. Don't tell that Rani sir has not taught us how to represent bearing. Now this is the actual case, and this is how we show in the drawing. Alright. This symbol stands for bearing. This you have to remember. Remember, because in theory of machines, when you learn theory of machines, when you learn, many times in the question, you will find, you know, that the shaft is supported on the bearings. They will not write it. They will simply say like this. You have to understand that's a bearing. That is, this is a bearing. If you have a bearing, that you have to understand. So this is other. If you don't want to use this symbol, then draw like this. So this is time consuming, isn't it? Time consuming, and it depends upon the skill of the draft, isn't it? So the function of the bearings, I'll tell you, 90% students, they don't know. They are not even at the end of the 4 years. Sorry. The function of the bearing is to improve the life of the shaft. How? Like, say this is shaft. Isn't it? And this shaft is rotating, isn't it? Shaft means it is rotating, and this shaft is rotating in a housing, suppose directly in the housing. Then because of the rotation, that housing gets damaged. Either housing will get damaged or the shaft will get damaged, whichever is weaker element. If the shaft is hardened, then the housing will get damaged. Housing means it is a kind of a hollow, a female. If the housing is hard relatively, then the shaft will get damaged. Then you have to replace, or you have to throw, or you have to salvage. Salvage means repair. You have to salvage, or you have to repair the shaft, or the housing, or the hub. So maybe in just 3-4 days it may get damaged. So every 3-4 days you have to change this shaft or housing. So in order to reduce this, we use a bearing. So bearing may, you have to remember two very important things. Of course, this is not a scope of AMD, but yes, since you're doing production engineering, I'm telling you, bearing may, there is one inner race and another outer race. Bharat ka jo outer race bolte hai, andar ka inner race. Race one, race two, picture, malum hai na? Two are separated by balls. Now, inner race is tight fit on the shaft, and the outer race is tight fit on the housing. So that means inner race, when the shaft rotates, the inner race will rotate. And ball, there is a ball in between inner race and outer race. Understand? So as the shaft rotates, inner race will rotate. Because of that, ball will rotate. Okay. And this outer race is tight fit in the housing. So since the ball rotates, it will rotate the entire housing. Isn't it? So that means there is no relative movement between up and the inner race and the housing. So the life, that is the shaft, will never get spoiled. The housing will also never get spoiled. What we want to spoil here? We want to spoil here bearing. हम लोग को bearing खराब कर रहे हैं. We want to save shaft and we want to save housing because these are costly and these are not available at the standard. These are tailor made depending upon our product. Whereas the bearing is a standard. What we are discussing, all machine elements, all standard components. So bearing is available at the standard. So हम लोग बोलते हैं ना अभी फैन का हवा जा रहा है, अरे बेरिंग गया ना, बेरिंग गया. So we are purposely making bearing as a weaker element so that we want it to get spoiled. Definitely not after 2 days. There is a design. Like suppose I design and manufacture a shaft. इसका की लाइफ रहेगा 1000 hours. I design and manufacture a housing. इसका की लाइफ रहेगा 1000 hours. Okay. Then I will use a bearing. इसका की लाइफ रहेगा 500 hours. Okay. So I see that my shaft and housing is not damaged, but my bearing is damaged because every machine element will have life. अपना भी लाइफ रहता है, बराबर ना, 70 years, 80 years, बाद में तो जाना ही है. So nothing is, you know, infinite life. So every element will have a life, isn't it? Depending upon what kind of material, etc. You use. So here I use a kind of a bearing which will fail in 500 hours. So after 500 hours, what I will see? My shaft is intact, my housing is intact, and bearing is damaged. So I'll just go to the market or go to the stores, ask for the bearings and fit it. Alright. So these bearings in a drawing is represented by this rectangle, and there are two lines, cross lines. Upper B or Niche means I know now there is a bearing. Then you write here, you give number. It is a short description here itself. If the description is long, just give a number here, number 10, and then something for the bomb, that is for the build up material. In the build up material, you have to write against part number 10. So 10 you write in the build up material, it's a table, tabular form. So there you write 10, against 10 you write ball bearing 2204. All the details what you want to mention and quantity, etc. You to write it in the bill of material. Now, here is a difference between the thread here, that is the next element. Now, here there are threading on both the sides. Threading on both the sides. So, this is called as the stud. Stud. S-T-U-D, stud. And this portion is square. So that you can have a spanner here, so that you can have a spanner. And external threads are represented with the symbol. This you'll be using many times. You have to draw inner circle, not complete. 3/4. You should cover 3 quadrants. not all the four quadrants. For external threat, inner circle, and for the internal threat, outer circle. 90% students make it ulta, garbad. Okay. And then on the board, instead of showing this design, you have to simply draw two lines, Aisa. So that represents your threading. This represents your threading. So this is internal thread and this is external thread. Simple. Remember, internal matlab 4 circle. External matlab, external thread means under se, like that you remember. External matlab under se 3-4 circle. Internal thread means R se opposite length. And then this is the assembly, that is, you have a headed bolt inside and in which a bolt is going inside. Okay, so now we'll continue, but before that, what I wanted to show you, I just wanted to show your, I wanted to share your attendance. So if there are any discrepancy, you just let me know. And I'll also take a roll call also. See, normally in Google Meet, we have auto attendance, attendance get generated automatically with the time. And even we have .csv file and we have .xls file. So what time you are joining, what time you are leaving, everything gets recorded and you also get in the bar form. I'll show you how the file looks like. If you, most of the teachers, they may not have shown you, but just, academic curiosity, I'll show you how does it looks like. Whether you don't, I'll show you how does that .csv file look like. I'll show it in the downloads for my earlier lecture. So this is your, there are two, and we don't have to tamper anything. Moment we leave the meeting or you leave, moment the host leaves the meeting, it gets downloaded. It is generated automatically. This is how, this is for your seniors. Like this, what time he joined? Morning I had lecture, 10 o'clock. So he had joined 9:51 and then he left at 10:30 again, which mein kidhar gayab ho gaya, and then last mein main roll call lene wala bola tha, he joined again. Okay, sir. So again, this is show joining time. So I said 3 minute, 5 minute wala, we don't give attendance. I said we don't give attendance. You know this guy, you know, Preet, he will not get attendance. And my timing is also recorded. This is .csv. It gets generated in Google Meet. It gets generated. That is the advantage. That's why we prefer Google Meet. The XLS file also gets generated. This is what XLS file, along with the 6th of August, you know, server. How does it calculate? So that we are also not so sure. No, कैसा था अभी ये 10:31 को join किया, 11 दो को छोड़ दिया वापस. दो बार मतलब ज्वाइन लेफ्ट ज्वाइन लेफ्ट, इससे तो ज्वाइन करने का छोड़ने का नहीं ना सीधा. मेनी स्टूडेंट डू लाइक दैट, बट वी आर हेल्पलेस. वी कैन नॉट हैव कंट्रोल ओवर दैट अनलेस वी मेक इट कंपलसरी दैट योर वीडियो शुड बी ऑन, देन ओनली वी कैन कंट्रोल. बट ऑफ कोर्स वी बिलीव यू, वी ट्रस्ट यू. सो नाउ प्लीज चेक इफ देयर एनी डिस्क्रिपेंसी, यू लेट मी नो. 3rd of August that will not be counted, but just for my, you know, just for my, you know, record, I have marked this. Only Uttar was present, so rest all were absent. That is one thing. Second thing is, there is one, you know, one gentleman known that. So now, yeah, just give me your presence. Say oh. Present, karke Adnan, take your attendance.
Sir, present. Sir, Adnan present.
Yeah, Advait. Otherwise, I'll be marking absent. Okay. Amo.
Present.
Anmol. Sahil, you just see if he's present, you let me know. Otherwise, I'll mark absent. Aniket, also check your attendance also. If it is wrongly marked as absent, please let me know. Aniket, Dhiraj, Dimple.
Present, sir.
हर्ष, सब लोग खाना खाने को गए क्या? हसनैन, यू आर देयर? नो, हसनैन वाज देयर. या माधवेंद्र,
प्रेजेंट सर.
ओला,
प्रेजेंट सर.
व्हाट अबाउट दिस ओमकार? साहिल, he is not reporting. What happened?
Sir, I talked to him. Sir, I talked to him.
Acha, he is under treatment?
No, sir, I don't know his reason. I'll ask him about his reason.
Yeah, please ask, because he has been, you know, absent since 16th of July. Please check and let me know.
Okay, sir, I'll let you know.
Yeah. Pranav?
Yes, sir, present.
Present, eh? Yeah, absent. Pranav.
Present, sir.
Renan, please check your attendance also. Rutika, Rutika,
present, sir.
He was there. Rutika, are you there or left?
Yes, present, sir. I'm there.
Sahil,
hello.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Mark you present. Those who are, I'm just marking absent only. So that means rest all are present. Bobde, Samyak.
Present, sir.
Sanskriti.
Present, sir.
Shubham. Absent. Siddhant.
Present, sir.
Upkar. उपकार है नहीं लास्ट लेक्चर यस्टरडे आल्सो यू आर नॉट देयर. बेलंका एब्सेंट. विशाल यश. ओके, व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल आल्सो चेक द अटेंडेंस आल्सो एंड दे माइट हैव लेफ्ट ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट यू नो 5-10 minutes. This happens usually, but I'll consider if they are you know present for more than 30 minutes. No, I'll consider. Don't worry, because definitely so many students are not absent. Let me see the count here. The count. So only 11 only count. Definitely so many students are not absent. So I'll go through the attendance list that generated. And I'll mark them present. But Sahil, tell them that you be present till the end of the lecture. Aisa nahi khali join karke bhago. You tell them, no?
Yeah, sir. Actually, sometimes there are network issues also, no?
Ah, yes. Yeah. That's why. But I'll just go to that.
And was present for today's lecture.
Who?
Hasnan.
Ah, he was present. Yeah, I know.
Yeah, so I guess he
So definitely, I see, once we leave, know that attendance sheet will be generated automatically. So I'll see that and accordingly I'll mark.
All right, sir. Anyways, I'll inform.
Yeah. Okay. So thank you so much. Huh? You can leave it. Huh?